so let's see if it's working. Yeah, you can see I set it to 22 and after 1 or 2 seconds it synchronized with the car. Hi guys, today I'm going to make a full walkthrough of our Tesla Cloud features integrated with the Tesla API. This will give you additional features and also will synchronize the temperature of the knob with your car. So let's get to it. There are multiple ways to reach the login section. One is from the settings, the other one is, for example, if you want to add a tile which is by cloud, you can go directly to the login. And the last one is from the knob. Once you are in the login screen, you should choose the region, North America or Europe, and then press sign in with Tesla. When you see this page, you should select all and press next. Now we open the Tesla website and here you should enter your Tesla credentials and proceed with the login. Keep in mind that we never store your passwords, they go directly to the Tesla server and they return to us a token that we use when we execute the commands. When you are done with the password and the email, you can press the sign in. And now you see the screen which I showed you earlier. Here you see what permissions you can give to the S3XY app. So by default, just select all of them and press allow. Now we will try to connect to the Tesla server. If it's successful, you will see the next screen. On this screen, you should switch to your Tesla app if you have more than one car and select the correct car that you want to sign up. But if you have only one car, you can skip this step and just press next. After pressing request, you will see this screen inside the Tesla app and by approving, you will give access of the S3XY app to the car. If you are a vehicle owner, you immediately see success here, but if you are not, you will see this screen and you should use the card in this case. Just follow the steps inside the Tesla app, put your card and confirm on the main screen. And now it's done, you can see that nhelp.com now has a virtual key on this vehicle. This will allow us to execute commands from the Tesla server. Once you are done here, you should go back to the S3XY buttons app and choose the same vehicle that you just added access to. In this case, I added access to our Highland. And that's it. By pressing done, you are all set up. Now you can add tiles or you can change the temperature of the knob, which will be synchronized with the car. Now let's add some of the new features on the tiles inside the S3XY app. So just go to actions and tap by cloud. We can try, for example, the climate on off. Okay, save the action. And now by pressing this tile, the HVAC should stop. After completing all these steps, the temperature of the knob will be synchronized with your car. So let's see if it's working. You can see I set it to 22 and after 1 or 2 seconds it synchronized with the car. The delay depends on the cellular coverage of your car and also how busy are the Tesla servers. For now Tesla supports mainly the climate features, but hopefully in the future they will add others like changing between cheer and sport. That's it for now, hope you find this video useful and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask our support or give your feedback inside the comments of this video. As always, make sure to subscribe to our channel because we would like to give you more and more content like this and explain how our features are working. See you in the next one.